Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Welcome to my channel. One of Excel's most popular and easy features to learn is autofill. I'm going to give you a lot of tips when I'm running through here about autofill. It's one of those items you just need to master if you want to be really productive in Excel. We're going to look at text, dates, numbers, using the fill feature in autofill. Let's dive in right now. One of Excel's most powerful features is autofill using the fill handle. Let's look at this right now. In the file that we have open, column E and column F have numbers in them, invoice amount and cost. I want to take the cost, subtract it from the invoice amount, and that's going to be our profit. I want to see how many records we have first. Go ahead and click on cell E2. Put your mouse on the bottom border and just double click. You could also do control and the down arrow key to get down there. 999 records. Put your mouse on the top border, double click just to get back to the top, and press the down arrow key one time. You should be back in cell E2. Go to G1, we're going to type in profit. Feel free to format it. Instead of making it bold and center, let's use the format painter. Click on F1. On the Home tab, select the Format Painter, and then select Profit. It'll copy the formatting. Go to cell G2. Just a simple formula here. Equals E2 minus F2. Control Enter to stay here. $3,876 is correct. Put your mouse in the bottom right corner of cell G2. Those crosshairs, that is called the fill handle. Double click and it'll autofill down the screen. Perfect. Feel free to test it. Bottom click, double click, and you jump to the bottom. Top, double click, and you jump to the top and hit the down arrow again. So all those numbers filled in. Let's keep going. I'm going to move over to the next worksheet and give you some tips about autofill. Feel free to change your zoom. I am in D1. I'm going to do the number 1, control enter. When I get my fill handle and I start dragging down column D, it keeps putting in the number 1. I'm going to run down to D15 and let go. I'm really expecting 1, 2, 3. I didn't get that. I'm going to use auto fill options and tell it to fill the series. There's 1 through 15. Do an undo. Another tip, if you want 1 through 15, when you get your fill handle and you realize it's going to keep giving you 1, hold down the control key and pull down. And now you notice you have the autofill with the plus sign. Let go of the mouse, let go of the control key. There's 1 through 15. One more third option just to show you this. Instead of left clicking autofill, I'm going to right click. And I am still going to drag down to 15. But when I let go, a right click menu appears and there is fill series right here. Perfect. And finally, the number 1 is still in cell D1. I am making this up. I need to go from the number 1 straight down column D to the number 900,000. Make sure the number 1 is selected. Home tab, over to the right, editing group, we're going to use fill, series. Do you want it to go columns or rows? I want to move down the screen, so I'm going to select columns. What value do you want to stop in? 900,000. Click OK. There you go. Test it. Bottom border. Double click. Perfect. Top. Double click. There's 1 through 900,000. Go over to column F1, type in the number 1, press enter, type in the number 6. Highlight them both, the 1 and the 6. Autofill crosshairs, and you'll see that I'm going to go 1, 6, 11, 16, 21, on and on. So you can put in a range, and Excel is smart enough to pick up that pattern. One feature we use with autofill all the time is dates. Let's go to the worksheet called dates. I have four products already listed for us. Go to cell B1. I want to do January 2025. Make sure you do the four-digit year. Control Enter. It knows it's a date. Look in the formula bar. Autofill. Get your fill handle. Drag over to the right and you can stop in column M. It will give you December of 2025. Quickly filling in those dates. Do an undo. I want quarters in here also. So now when you pull over to D, stop at D, get just the first 3 months of the year. I want that to be quarter one. You can do Q1, you can spell out quarter one, whatever you want. Control Enter. I do want this aligned to the right. It's just a matter of preference. You don't have to do that step. Watch how smart Excel is. Select B1 to E1, get your fill handle. When you keep pulling over to the right, April, May, June, quarter two. So you would just keep pulling this over till you get to quarter four and let go. Feel free to do bold, italics, put them in a font color if you want to. So there are some dates right there. Couple other tips about dates. Let's add a new worksheet at the bottom. Hit the plus symbol. I'm not going to name it, but in real life I would. Feel free to change your zoom. Go to cell D1. Put in the date. I'm making this date up. July 1st, 2024. Press enter. Click on that date. Get your fill handle. And autofill down as far as you want to. If you need to autofit the column, autofit the column. Go to cell E1. Again, July 1, 2024, Control Enter. We know we're going to get July 2nd, July 3rd, so this time I'm holding down the Control key again, autofilling down, and then letting go of Control if you want to keep going with July 1, 2024. A couple keyboard tips about dates. If you want the current date in your Excel spreadsheet and it to be static, that is Control Semicolon. Today happens to be Sunday, May 21st, 2023. That is Control Semicolon to get in the date. If you want the current time and again it to be static, it is Control Shift Semicolon. It is 8:47 in the morning right here. And autofill will also work with text. I clicked over on the text worksheet. I'm making this up. I'm gonna put in GA for Georgia, FL for Florida, and CA for California. Highlight those three states, get your autofill crosshairs, and if you notice, it keeps the pattern going with text. And you can stop that at any point you want to. Hope you enjoyed this short video on autofill. This is part of my Excel online training course that'll be out in June 2023. Have a great day. Thank you.